Riyad Abdulaziz from Diplomacy and Public Relations Department. Today I will be talking about negotiation in deeply divided society and will explain Iraq as a case study. First of all, we have to know what deeply divided society is. The general definition of deeply divided society is the society that is ethnically divided, in which they are shaped as political entities to gain political interest, and the differences are used to make a ground for segmentation of the society. Even that, Stephen Wolfe say, deeply divided society is the existence of two or more separated civil society, strongly linked with different ethnic groups. John McGree claimed that it's one society that is plural inside or divided. In order to understand what deeply divided society is, or what the phenomena are that are essential in understanding or analyzing a divided society, we have to know the later definitions, terms, and characteristics. One is political stability. Even that, stability is one of the important characteristics of democracy. But what is essential is quality, because too much stability is harmful for democracy, while quality is what shapes a good political stability. Second is ethnic groups. Ethnicity is really important to know about any state and analyze society. The fact is that through political and social action, ethnic communities are constructed over time, but their deconstruction, especially in deep division and conflict situation, is not easy. In our case, which is Iraq, this characteristic is so clearly seen, as Iraq is divided to many different ethnics, which we will be talking about more detail in minutes. The third and the essence of our discussion is negotiation. According to some scholars, negotiation is a social process which two or more parties interact in the search for an acceptable position with regard to their differences and concerning the same issue of conflicts. While having a lead is one of the pillars to any negotiation success or failure, the role of the political elites is fundamental for a negotiation in deeply divided society. As some argue, the agreement of elites is a condition needed for achieving an agreement in the first place, and the existence of their participation helps to determine the long-term stability of any agreement. Having a lead is politically represent the necessary piece of the conflict management puzzle. This top-down perspective has to be balanced by a bottom-up approach, which, however, cannot replace it. The bottom-up approach argues the importance of civil society and intra-group collaborations and relation as opposed to inter-group ones to manage or prevent conflicts in deeply divided societies. Another important block that we have to cover is to understand the factors encouraging negotiation and agreement in deeply divided society. According to Rado, the writer of Negotiation in Deeply Divided Society, in federal systems and divided societies, having democracy is a good factor for both negotiation and agreement. Even that intervention or mediation efforts are a vital part of the peace process provided. They decrease the concerns of the minority groups and the state in general. But military intervention decreases the probability of negotiation and reaching an agreement. Going on to highlight the negotiation models. on which can be the best in deeply divided society. We first have to understand that there are many different models according to different schools and practitioners. While some may say that principled negotiation is the best suited, most successful, proactive type of negotiation in those societies, both hard and soft types of negotiation are characteristic of asymmetric relations between conflictual parties. The process of negotiation is not that simple that it looks, as it has to be practiced on different levels in order to gain real results. We have four levels. The first one, the local sub-state levels. The second one, national state levels. The third one, regional levels. The fourth one, international or global levels. Going on to the concept of power sharing and how it affects a deeply divided society. Even that, power sharing is the only means and it can be considered as a tool for conflict prevention, management, or settlement. And it represents the best means by which to avoid conflict and to foster conciliatory practices in divided society, but it can also fail. Because on the social level and political as well, to a big extent, power sharing is a way to make society divided and makes the negotiation process even more difficult. Power sharing and this division that it creates can lead to more violence. This can be seen in Iraq case, as after 2003 and the governments that are formed based on power sharing lead to a more divided society instead of making a unified state. Even that, it's difficult to measure if that a state is depending on power sharing or not. But according to a power sharing index, PSI, the following factors can serve as explanatory variables. The first, group representations. Second, proportionality. Third, separation of powers. Fourth, qualified majority for constitution amendments. Inclusiveness of cabinets. Minority governments. Functional veto players. Veto power for political parties or groups. Segmental autonomy, including both symmetric and asymmetric autonomy. Federalism. Talking about Iraq, Iraq is a multi-ethnic and multi-religious country. Therefore, its society is deeply divided. It is consists of ethnic fragmentation and religion faction. Arabs, Kurds, Turkmens, and Assyrians. On the religion level, the Muslims are also divided on Shia and Sunni groups, Christian, Yazidis, and Kakis. Kurds are located in the north, Sunni Arabs are in the center, and the Shia Arabs are in the south. Throughout the country, the ethnic and religion factors are affecting every inch of the society and do make the fragmentation even deeper. The people of Iraq do not share one identity, belonging, or nationalism sense. That is why even that Iraq is a state, but the society is not one united sector. The absence of a real democratization process in the country is also a factor in making the society as it's currently. For more than 30 years, and under the rule of Ba'ath regime, violence and conflict were the most obvious characters of Iraq, and their roots stayed in the society, affecting the next generation. After the United States invasion to Iraq in 2003, which resulted in the collapse of Saddam Hussein regime and destroyed all the institutional structure of Iraq, did not stop the violence but lead to more conflict. Mean that could be seen was the War of Fallujah, the raising of terrorist groups like Al-Qaeda, and later the formation of Islamic State and sizing the second biggest city in Iraq for over 3 years. After 2003, the format that Bath for years have built collapsed, leading to a new stage of international balance of power. The oppressive regime was replaced by parliament and the federal system. Those who were oppressed were now the rulers. The Shia majority and the Kurds in the north were the new players of ruling game. 500,000 Sunni soldiers and security men were sent home without a real assistance or money. The Sunni were marginalized. The group that were in top for decades were now having not a real place in ruling as before. And there were also the external factors. The Iranian took the chance to intervene in a country that their former rulers were aggressively against them. They supported the one after one Shia prime minister, political parties, and peoples. The Arab country, on the other side, supported the Sunni and this because of anti-US and anti-West ideas. The deep belief that an Arab country was invaded by a foreigner. Even with all the challenges, after a series of negotiations in which US and international actors were acting as a mediators in Iraq, formed new government, institutions, constitutions, and hold elections. But the fight on corruption and violence never ended. The reality that all the governments after 2003 were based on the concepts and formats of power sharing facilitated the road to become a more deeply divided society, and the negotiation process were held in order to gain agreements, not to solve the deep disputes. That is why different problems among the groups are from time to time raised again as the continuation dispute between KRG and Baghdad. The structure of the government is built in a way that all the continents have a share, and this leads to more division, fragmentation, and dispute instead of making a real democratic based government that have to work for all the ethnics as one and for all. I am done now. Thank you for watching.